Aniket an aerodynamics engineer at Hyperloop IITB, and Apoorv Tiwari is doing a dual degree at Aerospace IIT Bombay. And so our first question is, what is the many students want to know how to prepare for IIT and other entrance exams, and so what is the application process?
Application process now for GE is coming simple. There is an online form you need to fill and pay the fees, and that's it. And then comes the preparation part. For preparation, mostly the syllabus isn't too vast. I mean, 2 years are more than enough. Some tips I would like to give are have a curious mind. Don't ignore the NCERT and revise wisely. These are sufficient for cracking any exam, not just GE.
Said I have a curious mind, and it is the concepts are overall centered around what the NCERT syllabus is, but it of course takes you much deeper than that, and has a lot more variety than that. You need more exposure, and you need to understand it deeply and thoroughly. You need to practice with the questions and all. So I mean, that's what the people in coaching do basically. They teach you concepts and help you solve questions. You can also do it on your own if you know exactly what to do. Just keep on stuff more, and you'll be able to track it. And for the process, I think it's pretty simple. You just go to the website and click on the form, submit it, then give the exam.
Great. And so there are many courses offered by engineering courses, such as chemical, computer, mechanical, electrical, and etc. So, can you describe what these courses cover and how students should decide which stream they would be best suited for?
Well, that is a pretty deep question. I mean, this call can go for hours, and still we won't be able to complete the span of the departments. But I'll just try to give a short summary. So, I was in aerospace, so I know in detail about what aerospace department offers. So I'll just start with that, and then I can maybe try to cover. I don't think I'll be able to do much justice to the departments, but I'll just try to summarize. So the aerospace department basically focuses more on the aviation side. And you learn about there are four verticals in aerodynamics mainly, in aerospace mainly. One is structures, one is aerodynamics, there's systems and control, and then there's propulsion. So those are the main four verticals, and each of them has a lot of courses covered in separate ways. You start building the basics, start with thermodynamics. For example, in propulsion, if you see, start with thermodynamics, then you move a bit up to turbo machinery, and then you get an overall idea for turbo machinery first. A turbo machinery is basically the jet engines that we have in the plane. And then you go to more specialized courses where you zoom into one particular section of the engine, learn more about it and all. So the same happens with the other three verticals as well. And in the space part, we don't have many courses. I think we have one on space flight mechanics. And I think we have, and one we have on, it's on space propulsion. But yeah, of course, more of the systems and controls courses are focused on space applications. But if you are wanting, if you want a career in space, then I don't think IIT Bombay is the right choice. But if you are more of an aviation enthusiast, so planes and all, aero stuff, then I think it's a pretty good place to be. And yeah, that was a very, very, really brief summary for my department. For other departments, I think mechanical focuses a lot on the structures side, structures vertical. So, by my experience, the courses for mechanic, the courses of structures and solid mechanics in mechanical are pretty nice. And as I said, I don't have really much exposure into other departments as such. In computer science, you'll be the courses are the entire course curriculum is pretty focused on the primary skill they want you to have, that's logical reasoning and coding languages. So I think they have one particular course where they teach you, I think, 11 languages in one semester. That's you have an assignment for a new coding language every week. Something like that. So there's some cool stuff happening. Then there's a lot of algorithms and stuff that you do in CS. I mean, like I think the best thing that you can do about if you want to know what happens in these departments is you can go to their particular websites. So individual departments have their own websites. And you can go there and you can check the curriculum. They have it in brief as well. They have a detailed explanation as well. You can check it out. I think some of the departments have really good web pages, so it will be really helpful. And yeah, in chemical, you focus more on the industrial aspect. So there's a misconception that a lot of people have about if you're good in chemistry, then you take chemical engineering. But that's really wrong, because chemical engineering is pretty different from what JEE chemistry or anything is, in fact. It focuses a lot on the industrial aspect of chemical plants and all. So you really don't use much of the basic chemistry that you learned. I mean, you do use it, of course, but not at that level which people feel. Like if you suck at chemistry, you can still do really good in chemical right away. There are for bachelor's, I think right now there are about 14 departments in IIT Bombay. So I think the best thing you can do is go to their individual websites and check it. And if you are unable to find them, you can just go to the main IIT Bombay homepage. That's iitb.ac.in. And you can just rummage to the website. Then you'll be able to find the department links and all. You might be able to see the faculties and stuff they do research on. If it's interesting, you can go and find out about.
All right, thank you so much. And so Aniket, can you tell us what you studied at IIT and like how it helped you become an aerodynamics engineer?
So actually I'm still IIT Bombay studying, not graduated. And Hyperloop IITB is a technical team. I mean, my department is chemical engineering. I am working as a aerodynamics engineer for like Apu said, there are 14 departments and but IDC, Industrial Design Center, that makes it 15, 20 multidisciplinary centers. One school of excellence, that's called from Shailesh Mehta School of Management. And we have interdisciplinary programs as well. So, I mean, and also like Abhu said, while deciding the branch, we should check the curriculum first. Like, obviously in chemical, we don't have chemistry that much. We have more maths than chemical. So we should check the curriculum as first, and then comes the exposure part. I mean, IIT Kharagpur might have some better branch exposure than IIT Bombay. But then, if you want to go in the non-core section and don't want to pursue in your branch, then IIT Bombay is more preferable than IIT Kharagpur, because Bombay is much larger city and you get more exposure than Kharagpur. So these are various aspects.
All right. Thank you so much, Aniket and Apoorv, and good luck.
Yes.
Thank you.